due to this spiral movement
Yes.
that's not in one plane but is in more than one plane.
Yes. And in another verse, it was that we've mentioned in a previous episode, it was about Alhamdulillah الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور.
Yes.
Also in this verse, there is mentioning of the alternation of day and night, and we mentioned also that it reminds people when you're sleeping, it's just like dying, and when you're waking, it's like going back to the day of resurrection.
Yes. Yes.
Is there any connection or any bond between these two verses, or does it indicate to the Muslim something?
بارك الله فيك. You see, the first verse, الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور. Allah is showing His boundaries, that without this careful planning in the creation of the universe, you could have never had that bright daylight.
Yes.
You see? And the alternation of darkness and lit part of the day is an essential factor for the development of life.
Yes.
Plants, animals, and humans. In plants, as we mentioned in the last episode, the role of plant in daylight, in sunshine, is completely different from the role at night. Similarly with animals, with humans, you see, the human body needs darkness for its rest and for the development of certain hormones and certain enzymes to allow the body to rest. And it needs sunshine during the day to produce hormones of activation that will help the various systems of the body to be vivid and alert and ready to work.
Yeah. Yes.
So this alternation is again a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Alhamdulillah.
I do have an inquiry here.
Yes.
Can we apply, Professor, can we apply this verse, وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّهَا, talking about the sun, all right, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَهَا, on different planets other than the Earth?
Yes, definitely. Every planet has got day and night. Every planet, even the moon, every moon has got day and night. Exactly. And that's why all heavenly bodies are globular. All heavenly bodies belong to a star like our sun. All heavenly bodies, these satellites, revolve around their own axes and then run around the central part, the sun, you see. So they all have day and night.
But it's like it's different, like the shortness of the day.
It varies, of course.
And it varies.
It varies, yes, greatly. Yeah, you see. Yes, see. The closer you are to the sun, the shorter the period. The farther away from the sun, the longer the period.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any further questions?
Mentioning the moon and the lunar revolution, is it really possible that we have a one-day difference between two adjacent countries?
You see, actually, the difference is due to ignorance. It's not due to... This is a universal event. It's not limited to a particular area on the surface of the globe. You see, if we have one single Islamic state that governs the whole Muslims all over the world, we will fast in exactly the same day, and we'll break fasting on exactly the same day. Because once the moon has been seen, the lunar month is born.
For all the world.
For the whole world, you see. Mm-hmm. We only have the local time differences, you see. And the local time differences do not exceed 12 hours between the farthest points of the globe, plus or minus. So you use the time differences, you see. So we can have the sunset here, 8 hours for America, for example, you see. I can use that difference. But the moon, once it has been seen, the lunar month is born and becomes obligatory on all Muslims to start their fasting. But this birth of the moon has to be after the sunset. It cannot be before the sunset because, as I said earlier, the day of the Muslim starts with sunset and the morning starts with the early hours of Fajr.
Why don't we have a sort of an association or an entity that organizes fasting for the entire Muslims in the
pray world? For the unity of the Muslim Ummah, and then this will happen, inshallah.
Is it something difficult to implement?
It's not difficult, you see. You see.
I mean, if one country sees the moon, and then
see,
and, the that, point, and we consider this
definitely.
For all.
Wallah, it's a shame that we fast on different days and break fasting on different days. It's really for adjacent countries.
Hajj times is
Hajj
is
time
the same.
We have to follow.
Everything is the same. It should be. It should
after
be.
Saudi. Yes. The Hajj is there.
Yes.
But I'm talking about Ramadan and Eid al-Fitr. You see, wallahi, akhi, it's a shame that we differ on that point, and we know that this is a universal event. If the month is born, if the moon is born, lunar new moon is born, the month is born. We have to begin that. And inshallah, if we become united again in one simple country as we used to be in the past, we will fast on the same day and break fasting on the same day, inshallah.
So let's pray for that. And we thank you very much for being here with us. It was a pleasure to have you, Professor Zahrul Nagar. And I also love to thank Abdurrahman Ismail and Mustafa Ismail for being here with us. Thank you very much. And my dear brothers and sisters, we come to the end of this episode of Quran and Science, and see you in the next episode. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bum, 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 bum